Hi there, and welcome to the Ice Tech Guide. In this instalment, we're going to look at tracking your ice trike. The tracking determines the alignment of the front wheels. If for any reason the tracking is out, it can affect your trike's handling and lead to uneven tyre wear. All ice trikes have their tracking factory set, so if your trike is new, it is ready to ride. The need for tracking can arise for a few different reasons. For example, changing steering parts, any form of crash or heavy knock the trike may sustain, or simply as part of a routine service. Tracking is done the same way on all current ice trike models. The tools needed for tracking are as follows: one 13mm open-ended spanner, one 5mm hex key, several straps or cable ties or some form of tape, and lastly, some form of adjustable tracking tools. Obviously at ICE we have dedicated tools which look like this, but you may need to be a little bit more creative. A short and a long tracking tool are needed to complete the job. Here are a few ideas that could be useful. Once you have some form of tracking tool, you can start the process of tracking your trike. There are several things you can do to make tracking easier. Firstly, getting the trike off the ground is beneficial, although not essential. Some form of trike stand makes the job a lot easier. Secondly, take the seat off your trike. This allows you to manoeuvre more freely around your trike and makes it much easier to place and see the tracking tool when working behind the cross axle. Once this is done, the steering needs to be secured in its central position using the straps or cable ties we mentioned earlier. What you are looking for when doing this is for the stem to be parallel with the main spar of the trike, like so. This should put the handlebar mid parallel with the trike's cross axle. Before continuing, it is worth checking that all the relevant parts of your steering setup are fitted correctly and done up tight. If you have front mudguards fitted, it is a good idea to remove them. It is also beneficial to remove your tyres for a better view of your rims. Once these parts have been removed, your steering setup is correct and set parallel, it is time to start tracking your trike. Now, what we are aiming for is for the trike to have approximately 2mm of toe-in on the front wheels. Toe-in puts the front of the wheels slightly closer together than the back of the wheels. Once you are sat on your trike, the weight distribution evens the wheels out straight. First of all, make sure that the trike's track rod lock nuts are undone using a 13mm spanner. This frees the track rod so it can be adjusted. Try to hold the track rod still when initially undoing the track rod nuts. Now take your short tracking tool and place it horizontally between the rim of the wheel and the main spar of the trike, forward of the cross axle. Now adjust its length until it touches at both ends. When placing your tracking tool against the trike's main spar, make sure it is always touching the widest part of the tube. As a side note, if you are using any form of metal tracking tool, be careful not to scratch the paint on the main spar. Now, without adjusting the length of your tracking tool, move to the rear of the wheel and once again place horizontally between the main spar and the rim. What you are looking for is a 1mm gap between the end of the tracking tool and the rim. If the gap is too large, it means the wheel is towed in too much. To remedy this, we need to adjust the wheel to close the gap at the back. This is done by turning the track rod towards you, like so. Remember that we are looking at very small adjustments here, so it won't need to be turned much. Once this is done, return to the front of the wheel and repeat the process. Once you have your tracking tool touching at both ends at the front and have a 1mm gap at the back, you can lock this track rod off. To do this, turn both ball joints back towards you like so, then, holding the track rod static, tighten the track rod lock nuts with a 13mm spanner. Once the track rod is tightened, you can turn the ball joints back to their central position. Once you have locked off the track rod, it is worth quickly checking that the wheel still has 1mm of toe-in. Now we have to track the second wheel. Where we track the first wheel to the frame, the second wheel is now tracked to the first wheel. So taking your long tracking tool, place it between the two wheel rims, forward of the cross axle and below the main spar, and adjust it so it is touching both rims. Then, without adjusting the length of your tracking tool, place it between the two rims at the rear of the wheels above the main spar. What we are looking for here is approximately a 2mm gap between one end of the tracking tool and the rim. If the tracking tool does not fit, the wheels are towed out. To correct this, shorten the tracking tool slightly and return to the front of the wheels. Now adjust the track rod until the rims are both touching the tracking tool. Then, return to the rear of the wheels and check again. If it still does not fit, repeat the process. If the gap is too large, you need to lengthen the tracking tool and adjust the front of the wheels out to fit the tool. Then, check to see if the gap at the back has now closed to 2mm. If the gap is still too large, repeat the process. Once you have the tracking tool touching both rims at the front and have a 2mm gap at the back, you can lock off the second track rod just as you did the first. Tracking can be a little trial and error until you get used to it, but as long as the end result is a 2mm gap at the back of the wheels and no gap at the front, then you've done a great job. Obviously, if you're struggling with this, it is always a good idea to take your trike to an ice dealer and get them to set the tracking for you, but hopefully this guide has made the job a little easier. Thanks for watching this instalment of the Ice Tech Guide, and we will see you soon for the next episode. To watch other Ice Tech Guide films, visit the Ice Trikes YouTube channel. For any other information, visit www.icetrikes.co or email us at sales@icetrikes.co.